Could there really be someone else like me nearby, trapped in the hellish summer camp nightmare? I have so many questions, but can only fit a few in my reply. Dear Penny, I was kidnapped too. Where are you from? How long have you been here? Send more balloons ASAP. From Billy. The next challenge is how do I get a response back to her. With the wind blowing westward, a balloon of my own would drift the wrong direction, away from Penny. And besides, where would I get a helium balloon? My mind races, but I pause when I vulgarly remember Nook selling a child's slingshot at his store. A crazy idea occurred to me. I purchased the slingshot as casual as possible. Honestly, I don't think Nook cares what I do anymore. A few days ago, I noticed an axe on display. Must have been a mistake. Was he really cocky enough to sell me a weapon? Was he taunting me? You might want to limit yourself to only cutting trees that are in the way. One of these days, Nook. Anyway, using the largest hollow seashell I could find, I tuck my folded up note inside and draw a glaring red X on the outside. I head to the eastern rock wall. With all the strength an exhausted child can muster, I raise my slingshot and let the message in a shell fly over the artificial looking wall. I was lucky. It cleared the peak. The wind, I could faintly hear the crumbling of loose gravel as it tumbled down the other side. I prayed my hunch would pay off. And once again, I was forced to wait. Forced to rely on the goodwill of a stranger who would inevitably let me down. While I wasn't digging, I was staring to the east, praying for the slightest hint of the sun glistening off of a shiny, inflated orb. I ran through all the hundreds of scenarios that would lead me to the invincible disappointment. Maybe Penny was caught and punished. Maybe she didn't exist. Maybe she's actually hundreds of miles away. Maybe she never found my letter. For all I know, it could be sitting on an empty plot of dirt, never to be seen again. The chance she'd find it and send another balloon was one in a million. And today, I had won the lottery. I ran like a starving lion chasing a gazelle. With my free time, I had been practicing my slingshot skills, and now I was a crack shot. In just two thongs, the package came tumbling down. I scooped it up giddily and snuck back to my house, tearing into the wrapping of the closest thing to the bridal joy I had felt since I got here. It was like Christmas Day for pals.
Dear Billy!
OMG, I can't believe it. I'm so happy. We have to keep writing. I've been alone for so long. From Penny. The time she had sent me a bottle filled with dirt, along with her letter, over time I came to realize that the items in the box were meaningless. All they did was weigh down the helium balloon so it wouldn't float off into the sun. The letters were the real treasure. In the next few weeks, Penny and I wrote each other in this way constantly and only operated at nighttime. She told me she used to send messages out to the ocean in bottles, but she had been caught and punished severely. For her birthday, her residents offered to get her one present of choice, and she had said that all she really wanted was one balloon every day until her next birthday to lift her spirits. She's a clever girl. We started getting into detail of each other's lives. What was the same and what was different? We both had freaky amble-like residents that would move in and leave at seemingly random times. We both had the same buildings. To my surprise and creeping horror, both of our towns were run by a raccoon calling himself Tom Nook. Though Penny tells me he used to be there every day and now she'd only see him once a week at best. We discussed the details of our camp. They sound very similar, so I asked her to send me a drawing of her town in the next letter. While I waited, I drew out a map of my own camp to send back. Though I had long ago became jaded by fucked up events in this camp, I have to admit, my stomach twisted when I finally saw her response. Except for a few tiny differences, it was almost identical to my map. Horror started to slink back into my adelid brain as a few puzzle pieces came together. I wrote back to Penny that night. Dear Penny, I think there might be more of us out there. A lot more. We have to find out. From Billy. Between Penny and myself, we got to work, slowly sending messages blindly in every direction with notes asking to spread the word. I borrowed some of her balloons and set them adrift in different directions. To equal delight and disgust, we started getting responses from every side. Jack, Sarah, Aaron, Jimmy, Philip, Emily. Names were starting to roll in, and most of them were confused and surprised that there was anyone else out there at all. Some were just a few weeks into their ordeal. Some have been captives for years. All of them were scared. I started receiving balloon packages at an alarming rate. I began to worry that someone would notice. We requested maps from our friends in an attempt to figure out where we were or a way to escape. As various drawings started to come together, I never got used to the fact that they were all virtually carbon copies, all walled in outdoor cages. I was surprised to find myself start to get excited. Maybe between all of us we can do it. Maybe we really can escape from this hell. But something was bothering me logically. Something didn't make sense about these maps. I decided to conduct an experiment. I had borrowed a lot of blank patterns from our semestress, who was starting to get a little suspicious of my newfound interest in fashion design. On each square, I began piercing together the map I had gotten, drawing in their locations as closely as I could figure. I used blue to show the beach area and brown lines to show the camp walls. Little white lines were marked the gates leading out of each camp. It turns out the camps shared walls, which luckily for us was the only thing that allowed Penny to find our messages. I put a big X over my camp and an O on Penny's. Over time, the bigger image started to form in my head, trying to figure out where everyone was located in relation to each other was turning out to be tricky, and I had to break it out into several large sheets. I needed a space wide enough to lay all this out and get a good look. In the dead of night, I dragged out my creation behind the museum where nobody would see me and started to put together the puzzle I had stretched together thanks to the work of a dozen small bruised and bleeding hands. Crap, how big is this place? Oh god. Oh god, no, please don't be right. A fucking island? For the first time in months, I fell to my knees and cried.